We are back for another exciting episode of The Spicy Life. I am your relationship expert and magnetic matchmaker, Spicy Mari. And on today's episode, we have the amazing, the beautiful abundance mindset coach, Lauren Treline, in the building. Round of applause. Lauren Treline is a human consciousness and mindset expert helping entrepreneurs and change makers create large scale impact in the world. She's the founder of the Abundant Entrepreneur Accelerator and the Abundant Alchemist, guiding coaches and entrepreneurs around the world to step in their full abundant potential through business strategy, money mindset, and vibrational alignment. Lauren hosts the Modern Alchemist podcast, sharing the wisdom and strategies of some of the biggest change makers in the world. And Lauren is an Aussie currently residing in LA, although you are in Australia right this second, right? Yeah. And it's with her puppy, Fernando. But happy that you were able to join me. I know you are always busy helping people live their best lives.
Thank you for having me. This is my favorite topic of conversation, so I have to turn up and talk about it. It's the best.
Yes, I feel like people are at a deficit right now when it comes to love, when it comes to just even raising their relationship frequency and the vibration that they're on. And so you've been sharing kind of with me that you've been taking this time and really focused on self-love and self-worth. And so, of course, I have to have you on the show to kind of get into some of that juicy stuff with me. But for those who are new to some of this language, speak to me about vibration. What is your take on vibration?
Yeah, I love to keep things super simple. So the way that I describe it is that we're all energy. Everything like this computer that we're looking at, your microphone, you and I, we're just energy in motion. We perceive ourselves as being solid. We think these things are solid, but no, it's really just energy in motion, right? So when we talk about vibration, it's about understanding that if you want to attract something in your life, all you ever have to do is be an energetic or vibrational match for that thing. And so we're just antennas, right? We're always emitting this energy, this vibration, this frequency. So it becomes really, really simple. We understand the fundamentals of that. Mm-hmm. And so that's how I like to explain it to people. Like, your vibe is everything. You want to change your internal world, you just shift your internal reality. It gets really easy and simple that way.
For people who feel like, and I get this all the time when I'm working with clients, they're like, I don't really know. Vibration sounds woo-woo. And I actually go into the science of it, that your vibration is actually a wavelength, frequency, and a color spectrum that really is scientific when it comes to all of us being made from atoms and that creating energy. So I love how you like simplify that, because going into the actual like science behind it sometimes can be overwhelming. But it's definitely something that we all are, you know, emanating at a continuous rate, and that rate and speed in which we do it plays over and over and over on rotation. And so you start to like actually give off an energy and a vibration that other people can feel.
Most people, we think our way through life, but actually our brain emits its own electromagnetic field, but the electromagnetic field of the heart is something like 1,000 times more powerful than the brain's. Mm-hmm. So our heart, whether we realize it or not, sends out electromagnetic signals into the world around us. And that's how we literally draw things in.
Yes. And part of where I think people get tripped up on when it comes to like law of attraction is that they're going to say something like 1,000 times over, but they don't necessarily believe it. And so, yeah. And so that's where they get tripped up on, because law of vibration says, no, you actually have to feel it and think it. It's not enough to just like tell yourself that over and over. You have to believe in it in order for you to actually gravitate that thing magnetically to you. And so that's where people get tripped up on when it comes to love too. Cause they're like, well, I really want love. I'm like, but do you believe that you can have love? And so that's where people get stuck. So I love that you do so much with like energy work, but talk to me about money. Right now we are in this crazy time where we are somewhat living in fear. We're seeing that the unemployment rate is skyrocketing and people aren't knowing like if they're going to get, you know, their next check or their next bonus, or even if they're going to have a job within the next few months. And some people have already lost it. How are you telling people, or what are you advising people to do in order to raise their vibration when we feel like distraught?
Yeah. So firstly, I think it's important to note that whatever we're experiencing is simply amplifying what was already within us to begin with. Like you didn't wake up in fear and scarcity. You've always been sitting in that. And so current stresses and circumstances are just amplifying what's going on anyway. So we have to recognize that there are multiple realities at play. So not everyone is in fear and scarcity. Some people are actually having a really great time at the moment, which might be hard to comprehend. Yeah, like I'm feeling really, really peaceful, but that's because I emanate peace, right? So this is actually an incredible time for us to have all of our remnant old money stories, scarcity stories, fear coming up to the surface so it's amplified and so we can see it, in order for us to be able to look at it and heal it and clear it out of our system.
Certain things we may know or may be aware and even conscious of when it comes to, like, me for relationships, you for money. You are a money magnet. I'm a relationship magnet, love magnet. Sometimes we forget that we can apply those same tools and method of vibration to the other elements of our lives. And it's easy to forget, which is why I think it speaks to how important it is that you have a tribe that's, you know, living in abundance and that has that mindset. But some people don't even know what abundance is. Can you speak to an abundance mindset?
Yeah, totally. And that's a really great point. So what we have to do first is we have to recognize, firstly, that we're humans and we tell stories. Mm-hmm. So our perception of reality, we're only ever seeing through our own lens and our own eyes, right? So the two people can witness the same thing happening in front of them and have two very different perspectives. So we need to recognize if we're feeling fear and scarcity, we're actually viewing the world through a fear and scarcity lens. Mm-hmm. For some people, this is the worst thing that's ever happening. For other people, this is the greatest awakening that's ever happening. So then when we realize that we're telling stories, we come to the next point in all of this, which is recognizing that we have a choice as to what story we want to tell.
Yeah.
And this is really, really, really big. And the challenge is that most of us have been conditioned and brought into a system where we're told that you are only abundant if you have done X, Y, Z and have A, B, C. And the problem is, like, because most of us look and we're like, oh, I don't have that in my bank account. I don't have that purpose mate that I've been looking for. I don't have that house. I don't have all of these things. Therefore, I am not abundant.
Yeah.
And yet it's not true, because, like, we are, as human beings, born into abundance, and we always have been. So we need to start by telling a better story. And the story is that, and the rules that we have around those stories is that I'm abundant regardless of whether or not my purpose mate has turned up, whether or not I have the money in my account today, whether or not X, Y, and Z has happened. Because we know that in order to manifest what we want, let's say it's abundance, I need to first be a vibrational match for abundance.
Yeah.
And so we do that by telling better stories, by creating easier rules. So I just got off the phone with a bunch of my students and I got them to write a definition of abundance that was so easy, spicy, they couldn't fail. Because they were like, I will feel abundant when I have my husband and my three kids and I have zero debt and like XYZ. I was like, guys, that's really complicated. You're pushing your abundance out into the future as opposed to feeling it now.
Yeah.
And the truth is, like, if you live in America, it doesn't matter how hard things are at the moment, you are abundant. Mm-hmm. You are. Whether or not you feel like you're not, whether or not someone's telling you that you're not, regardless of your current circumstances in that moment, you are abundant.
And if that speaks to, like, if you're dissatisfied with where you're at, with who you are, with what you have, it would be even harder to attract those things that you desire more. Because I think even you have helped me with understanding that, like, desire actually lies on a lower level of frequency when it comes to, like, bringing that thing in, because you're constantly recognizing that you are without. And so, yeah. And so it's like almost like you have to be in this place of gratitude and appreciation for what you have, which is something that I speak heavily to when it comes to people who come to me and they're like, okay, I know I spent the last 30 years jacking up my love life and playing by my rules, but now I need you to come in this year and just fix it for me. And I'm like, wait, First off, let's acknowledge where you are, what you've learned from those things, operate from a place of great, you know, gratitude to, you know, the decisions you've made and how you've overcome. And then we can move forward and like actually gaining the things that you say that you want. But yes. Even not even necessarily what you want, what do you need? Like, let's even look at what you need. And so I want to hear what you need right now, because you, my friend, are single. And you just happen yeah. to be friends with the matchmaker. So I'm constantly on the hunt for you. But in a particular yeah. situation where people may look at us teaching these methods of, you know, laws mm-hmm. of attraction, they may even say to us, okay, well, Spicy, why aren't you rich yet? Lauren, why aren't you married yet? If you can live this abundant life, for those naysayers who don't understand the process, what do you say to them?
Yeah, so each one of us is on our own journey. And so this is what we need to realize, that sometimes the lesson to be learned from the journey is more important than getting the thing that you want because you cannot put a price on that. So the woman that I become and am becoming in order to call in my purpose mate, there is no way you can shortcut that journey for me to attract that incredible man that I know already exists and will meet me when we are both ready. Like, you cannot shortcut that. And so I've fallen in love with that process because I can see the shifts and the changes. And I know that when me and that man meet, that it was worth, the journey was worth it in order to get there, because that's everything that I've wanted.
And even seeing your growth in your relationship journey, I know that you are an incredible person that is ready for love and you are actually calling in love. But I think that there was still that lesson to be learned of you falling more in love with yourself, more in love with the process. Because if it was just handed to you, you may not have been as grateful for him 3 years ago. You know, he just fell on your lap, which majority of the time happens. We will pass up on a great person because there is still a lesson to be learned. We're not where we should be in our development. And so we miss out on our blessings.
And I know that life is always guiding me to become the woman that I'm supposed to be, and then the rest of it's taken care of. So it's like I'm my own soulmate, I'm my own purpose mate, and then my purpose mate has to turn up. I'm the millionaire before my first million arrives in my bank account.
Yep.
It's always that way. And so if we can go even deeper on this and we can talk quantum physics, we create in the quantum field before it turns up in our physical reality. Mm-hmm. So I need to know with complete alignment and total certainty from a beliefs perspective, from a behavioral perspective, from an energetic perspective, that I am worthy of my purpose mate. And then it's simply just a matter of time passing before that turns up in my life.
And that's how it turns into the belief, right? You know that your thoughts, emotions, beliefs, and behaviors are now in alignment to receive the goals you have aspired for. And I think sometimes we forget too that yes, we're doing all of these things to, you know, be in alignment to receive, but guess what? You're also working with a partner who may potentially be being worked on as we speak. He just may not be ready right this very second. Like, there's several things at play. He may still be going through, you know, his process, through his coaching. I literally am a testimony to, you and I both have worked together, but I think I didn't realize how much I'm in love with love, but wasn't in love with money. And I was operating from a place of fear, thinking like, why am I not, you know, driving the, you know, revenue that I've been desiring? Like, I'm working so hard, I'm walking in my purpose. And I think you helped me come to a place understanding even that there were some childhood, you know, memories in play, that there were some elements of, you know, fear that were coming to the surface, that oftentimes I was making decisions out of fear. I was making, you know, decisions out of drought, out of being, you know, without, as opposed to me knowing I need to be making decisions out of love and not fear. And so anyone who is struggling right now with where to drive their business and sales, like, Lauren is the person you want to talk to. But in exchange, you also, you know, got you, like, even with your coaching, you get to remind yourself too with your daily information, like, you're feeding your spirit at the same time by helping other people.
Yeah, it's the ultimate hack. Like, we've set it up so well, Spicy, that we get to help other people and then learn so much in the process. It's the ultimate gift. Like, I learn so much. And this is the thing, like, relationships and money and business, these are all tools that we have created to facilitate our evolution as a human.
Yeah.
And so we have to like fall in love with that. But like, this is a journey. It was never about the destination. It really wasn't, because there is no destination. That's an illusion.
Can I put your business just a little bit on blast? In fear, I'm gonna make you be like vulnerable in a second. When Lauren and I talked about her love life, because we both put each other back and forth in the, you know, seats. when you had shared with me what was on like your list and the things that you were looking for and what you were trying to draw into you and a partner, you had mentioned like, I don't think that I can attract an attractive person. I don't know if I really believe that I'm capable of that. And I'm like, what? Here you are telling me I can make $1 million, but you don't think you're even worthy or capable of drawing in someone attractive. And so that was a limiting belief right there. And you were, dating people who didn't necessarily match how beautiful they weren't as equally externally yoked as you were.
Accurate.
We had to do some shifting, right? We had to do some shifting in those, you know, beliefs. But how do you do that shift? What is it? Speak to some of the things that you do for self to get you out of that mindset, like of the can't, of the what you cannot draw into you.
Yeah. And so like, and if we can even play with what you and I discussed, like as soon as we identified that, like I'm a fast learner. You've seen that yourself.
Right? You're amazing. You're amazing.
And so like Spicy saw it in real time. As soon as I let go of that, all of a sudden I start attracting attractive men. Soon as I let go of the belief. And so this is, once again, the first piece around this is awareness. Like you don't know what you don't know. So if, say, for example, someone has an abundance story or a money story or a relationship story, a great question to ask, like say, for example, you want to call in your purpose mate.
Yep.
A great question to ask is like, if I was to know, what would be blocking me from allowing this in my life? And then you're going to have a whole list of stories like, I'm not good enough. Like, who am I to think that I get to have this? Like, I weigh too much, or that man doesn't exist. And we're going to see all of those old beliefs, and they're just beliefs, right? They're just stories. Yep. They're not necessarily true. That need to come to the surface in order to be healed, in order to be rewritten, and in order to be replaced with a belief that serves us in achieving what we want to achieve.
It's just a shift in beliefs.
It is. It is. And then it's never about the external. It's always about the internal. So as soon as I shift the belief that Lauren is worthy of a really attractive man, guess what? And turns up, you know, it's so funny how that
works. It sounds crazy to say that. People are probably like, well, no, you know, because, but honestly, I don't get one person who doesn't ask for someone attractive. So to hear you being so beautiful and you're like, no, yeah, that's not, I can't have that. I'm like, what? You are incredible. So you see, I'm like marketing you as we speak. When this episode, I'm like, please, you know, email me at info@thespicylife.com. Lauren is single right now, and I am going to get her matched to her purpose mate.
And like, that's a good point that you bring up. And so I can tell myself, and this is the same thing with money, whatever it is. I'm ready for my purpose mate. I'm ready for my purpose mate. I'm ready for my purpose mate. But if a version of us is still holding on to that time that we were bullied and told we were ugly when we were 10 years old, which I experienced, you and I unraveled that. If that version, that 10-year-old version of me says, but you're not pretty, you're not good enough for that, who are you to deserve that?
Yeah.
I'm going to block myself. And that's the resistance. That's what stops me from being a match for what I want. And so there's no greater work that we can do when it comes to manifesting, healing work. That's it. Self-development, healing is the key to this entire equation.
One thing that I know, like when we check in with each other, you're always like, oh, I'm working on this. I'm working on that. Right now I'm working on self-love. I want to know what you're doing right now during this isolation time, because there's a lot of people who are single and really feeling it. I think I mentioned to you, like, I'm excited because for the first time, I think people are realizing the value of companionship, that it's not enough to just have like a sleeping buddy, you know, or a side boo, or like someone, you know, who comes in, comes out, because that's not possible right now with like what's going on with quarantine. And so now people are really starting to think like, maybe I should be settling down. Maybe I should be focusing on, you know, self and, you know, healing. What are you doing right now to focus on self-love in preparation for your purpose mate?
Yeah, so it's a really good question. So once again, it's always internal. Journaling is really, really powerful, bringing all of this stuff up to the surface and clearing it. And so it doesn't matter what modalities you use, whether it's using something like the emotional freedom technique to clear old beliefs out of your system, energy work, working with a coach, working with someone that specializes in like EMDR. There's so many different therapies and modalities that we can use and that we can start doing on ourselves through like self-hypnosis and, like I said, EFT, or investing in someone that can do the work for us. So the biggest challenge that we have as human beings is that our subconscious doesn't want to take us to the parts that are uncomfortable. So look at that, you know, mummy or daddy wounds that we have that needs to be addressed, because that's really what's blocking us. And it's like, oh, no, there's nothing to see here. Don't look here.
Yeah.
And then we're good. We distract ourselves. We go on some, you know, you have like a guy that's not good enough for you, but you're distracting yourself with it. You're out drinking. You're out hanging out with friends. You're on your phone. And so we're numbing all of that. And what's beautiful is that all of this old trauma and the old wounds can come to the surface now to be healed. And so we have the opportunity to make some massive shifts in our life and up-level our abundance in all shapes and forms by facing the stuff that we have been conveniently avoiding to look at because we've been so fast-paced and busy.
But when they're not aware, though, so like what advice do you have for folks who like, there's nothing wrong with me. It doesn't exist. I'm great. I'm amazing. There's nothing wrong with these bad habits. Yes. How do they bring to the surface things that they're not even conscious about?
Yeah. So number one is that if you don't have what you want and it's not in your life already, you know that something needs to be worked on. Like otherwise, it would be there, right? And that's kind of uncomfortable for us to admit.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Maybe it's not that ex-boyfriend that's the problem or my ex-wife. Maybe it's something within me that needs to be worked on. So that's the first piece, acknowledgement, right? Taking radical responsibility as an adult and not blaming others. Being like, cool, I created this situation. The good thing is I get to be the one that solves the situation.
Right.
That's empowering.
Gratifying too.
It is. It really, really is. And then it's about the piece around awareness. So like knowing you don't know what you don't know. So whether that is like listening to amazing podcasts like this, reading books, and getting really real and honest with yourself and being like, oh, cool, now I can start to see where some of my blind spots are. The second piece around transformation and creating lasting change is clearing. And so I would say the best way to do that is to hire someone to do it with you so you can't escape. Like, you know, when you call me out on my stuff, Spicy, and I'm sitting there, I'm like, I am so uncomfortable right now. I want to run. And you've experienced that working with me as well.
Like, absolutely. I'm like,
exactly. Like, I got to go home and process this. Like, there's nothing more valuable than having another fellow human being that loves you and cares for you. And this isn't a family member, someone external that can lovingly call you out on your BS and be like, that thing over there, you need to go look at it.
See, and this is why your vibe is your tribe. Yep. It's accountability.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Accountability and radical responsibility. And then the third piece of the puzzle is aligned action. So I've got an awareness now. The second part is like I'm doing the work to clear out of my system. And then I have to start taking aligned action and behaving in a way that is congruent with the new set of circumstances that I want to create in my life. That's kind of the formula.
I almost call it or refer to it when I'm working with people who I know are having a hard time in the belief part. When I do thoughts, emotions, belief, behavior, I know, okay, it's hard for me to get you to believe this thing right this second. So we are going to rig the system and we're going to work on the behavior so that you can start feeling a certain way. Then now your belief will start to shift, because I can't just automatically, I can try to give you as many affirmations as possible, but to shift your emotions and your beliefs that control that takes a lot. So if I can, so that's why, like when we do, you know, spicy activities or we're doing like some of the exercises and work, a lot of it is grounded in helping with your belief system and getting you to a place where you start to reap some of the benefits of this behavior. And then that helps shift with the belief as well. It takes a lot to like unpack, you know, unpackage and unwind all of the things that you've been doing, you know, your entire life.
Totally. And that's a really good point. Like that's a really important part of this, because if we were supposed to come down to earth and just read books and listen to podcasts, we would master life. You listen to this podcast, problem solve, here's my purpose, mate, right? Like, I wish it was that easy. But we know that that's not the case. Like, people are consuming junkies, right? So what we don't realize is, like, we are here to have a human experience.
Yeah.
And so as soon as I've grasped some of the knowledge, it is my duty to go out in the world and test that and see whether or not it has worked, whether or not there's some tweaking to do, whether or not something has to be changed. And so, like, I love that idea of, cool, now I think I have this new belief, so I'm going to go back out there and dating and, like, let's see where I land. Let's see what I've learned. And then I adjust accordingly. So you know you're doing something right when it comes to dating, when you are seeing that you're meeting better and better and attracting better and better people on the journey. Like, you know that you're on the right path then.
Yeah. It's a case that you are gathering information and then learning from that and then saying, okay, next relationship, next dating experience, I know I need more of this, or maybe I can do this differently. None of us are perfect in our dating experiences or any, I mean, we have a multitude of stories we could probably share that are like, you did that. But all of it is serving a bigger purpose and it makes you who you are. But you can also really transform your dating experience by the choices that you make and the people who you choose to keep around you.
Completely, completely.
And so are you dating better quality people?
I've seen it through time. Like, I definitely am. I know like that I'm getting so close.
If there's that line, there's that threshold. I love that you're saying, like, you feel it, you know that you're getting closer. What, for those people who are like right there, okay, they've done the work, they've, you know, are putting themselves in a position to, you know, be social and meet, but then quarantine happens and they're like, crap, now how do I meet people? This is where I know I step in and I'm like, okay, I'm available to help because I'm, you know, setting up dates from behind the scenes. But for people who don't know that we exist, for people who don't know who that they can get help, you know, with their finances and building their business as, you know, in the Abundance Coach program, or people who don't know that the Spicy Life exists, they're just tuning in. What can we tell them to keep hope alive?
Yeah, so two aspects to this. Firstly, I want to share a quick story with you. The day that I started doing more of the self-love work the other day, mm-hmm. I was like, this is the next way for me to go in deeper because I know it expands into my love relationships, my personal, my relationship with self, money, everything gets taken care of when you go deeper into self-love. Self-love is key, right? I sat down to do a self-love meditation and then I get a message that there's some post for me to pick up from the post office mm-hmm. that was supposed to be on my doorstep. I go pick it up. One of my clients had sent me a love package.
Oh.
So on the package, it says, you are deeply loved. Mm-hmm. And so my subconscious had to, and you guys need to hear this, whoever's listening to this, love literally turned up at my doorstep.
Great testimony.
Awesome, right? I was like, okay, universe has a sense of humor. Like, love literally turned up at my doorstep. I didn't have to do anything. I just had to be love.
Mm-hmm.
So the only thing that limits us from like a manifesting what we want is a belief as to whether or not it can happen. So this is where creativity comes into it. We have to get creative. So I sit in bed and I'm like, oh, I wonder what it would look like for my purpose mate to turn up. Will they turn up off an app? Will I be introduced to someone? Yes. Will Spicy send them my way? Will I go to the shops or the coffee shop and meet them at the coffee shop? And like, can you see how I'm like playing in the field of infinite possibilities?
Yeah.
And I'm playful with it. I'm like, that person, they already exist. They're already born, which is convenient. They already exist. And so I open myself up through the power of curiosity and imagination, and I start to wonder how that could potentially unfold without attachment as to how it can turn up, because I just saw that it can turn up at my doorstep.
And what you're not doing is saying or eliminating the house, which oftentimes I will hear people say, it will never be online. It will never be, you know, at a bar. It'll never be like... I don't want to hear any of
you
that.
You don't know that.
You don't know
exactly that. You don't know that. Like, I've had matchmakers message me out of nowhere and they're like, hey, like, we want to add you to our database. Like, I didn't know I was going to meet you. I didn't realize I was going to be seated next to that person on the plane that you end up dating or the person that I met at the bar.
Yeah.
The how is not our business. Correct. How the universe delivers to us has nothing to do with us. Our only job is to be a match for what we want.
Yes, that's absolutely true. I couldn't Yes, exactly. But part of that is you also having to exude love, you having to radiate love, because you cannot ask or desire something that you are not giving. So if you are walking around unpleasant, upset, angry with the world, or resistant to it, even saying, you know, oftentimes I hear people coming in like, I'm unapproachable, or, you know, I just am so intimidating. That's why I don't have it. No, you aren't giving love. If people are feeling intimidation from you, then you aren't coming from a place of love. You need to be open and welcoming to whomever, whatever is coming your way. And that doesn't mean like being willy-nilly. I'm not even talking about spreading your legs. What I'm talking about, because people can go left, what I'm talking about is you being friendly and kind. The definition of love, love is good. Love is good. Love is kind. So it has more to do with what you are giving people in order to receive that. And I love your example of love showing up at your door, because oftentimes we will discount it if it doesn't look like what we thought. I thought it was a man. Oh no, it's a package from a client. And we will say, nope, I don't have love. That is absolutely love. It comes in many different forms. You called that in.
Yeah, but we discount it. Oh, that, yeah, like you said, it didn't turn up in the package that I wanted, therefore that's not it. No, it is it.
It was literally packaged.
You are loved. And I'm like, everything, it was like a love pack. So there was like tea with love on it, a candle with love on it. I was like, if this isn't a clear sign that love is here for me already, then I don't know what is, right? And it's so true. It's like, for me, the journey has been, and this is, doesn't matter whether it's business, money, relationships, love, is falling in love with myself.
Yeah.
Becoming such a radiant human being that, like, as one of my mentors said, he was like, Lauren, go fall in love with life so that life can't help but fall in love with you.
Absolutely. And that even begins with liking yourself. So love may be too extreme for some people who are suffering with a lack of self-love. Maybe we just get you to a place where you like who you are, the things that you do, the things that, you know, you say. Do you like that person who you are projecting to the world? Because if you don't like them, chances are other people don't as well. And so you start with like, and then you start to learn to love yourself, because it is a process. I don't want people to think that like, okay, today I'm going to love myself and they can just turn it on. It is really liking all that makes you, you, the way that you speak, the way that you walk, the way that you talk, everything that embodies you, the choices that you make, love those choices, fall in love with the choices that you make. Like, oh my God, I'm really a decision maker. I'm in love with like the choices that I make when it comes to choosing friends. I'm like really good at it.
And it's so true. And it's, you know, it's as simple as start looking in the mirror and noticing what you enjoy about yourself. Because remember, we're just the person that we meet is only ever a reflection of us. So if I can't lie in bed at night and tell myself how much I love myself and how incredible I am for having turned up today and given the day my best, if I'm not willing to do that to myself, I'm not able to do that for someone else. And if I think I can, I'm just kidding myself. It's not real love.
Yeah. And it's more than just self-care, right, Lauren? It's not enough to just like get yourself a mani and pedi or like do your hair every morning. It's more than just like the lying in the bath, you know, in the bathtub and like bubble bath going. Those are elements of like pampering yourself. That's not necessarily self-love. Self-care is a part of self-love.
Yeah. And I did a post on this yesterday, this very thing. Like we think that we're never going deep enough, right? So self-love sometimes, I talked about this yesterday, was sometimes self-love is getting a mani-pedi. And another day, self-love is saying like, I'm not going to date these men anymore under any circumstances. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to place myself in these toxic situations. I'm not going to allow my loose boundaries that I've had.
Yeah.
Like, can you see how it gets to be different? And it's going to look different every single moment. Like, yeah, some days it might be getting my eyelashes done, but another day it might be that I need to go have a conversation with someone where I haven't been truthful about what I really need and want.
Yep.
And that is the most loving thing that I can do for myself in that moment.
And that's what it sounds like you're saying too, is a part of it is the first step is also the self-acceptance, accepting, you know, who you are, what you have to offer. And then the second component is accepting of, because actually self-acceptance does make you more accepting of others. So it makes you also more flexible and easygoing. But the self-acceptance component, if you really accept yourself and you are lovable, What you won't accept is anyone who doesn't love you the way that you deserve to be loved. So the more love that you give on yourself, the less likely you are to settle for someone who's not equally yoked, for someone who doesn't appreciate all of the amazing things that you have to offer. And people do love differently. Somebody may not be as equipped to love you the way that you deserve, but you love yourself so much that you're able to recognize it.
Completely. And a great question to ask is, if I truly loved myself, would I do this, or would I allow myself to be in this situation? And most of us get that mixed up. It's coming from a defensive place, or a place of like scarcity and fear, right? But if I truly, truly, truly loved and honored myself, I would know that this person probably isn't the right person for me, or that I've been settling for too less, or like I really don't have to put up with that. And then instead of projecting that blame onto that individual, I go inwards and I ask myself, what aspect of me allowed this to happen? Yep. What aspect of me needs to be healed that brought this and invited this into my life? What do I need to look at in order for me to dissolve this old pattern of behavior so that I can step into the next thing? And we do it from a place of deep love and compassion. It's like, oh, look at you. Like the version of you that did that, that was the best you knew until now.
Until now. Right. Until now. I don't want to let people off the hook, because also too, we do show up and participate in these relationships. And so some of it is, yes, the person who we chose, which we have to take accountability for, but it's also too sometimes how we show up. We may not be in our full maturity. We may not be in our full self-love. So that person who's not, you know, their full self may be showing tendencies that are annoying or projecting insecurities or actually making the person react to them emotionally, or because it is an energy like balance between both of you. Maybe I'm not sitting in my feminine, I'm sitting in my masculine, and he's sitting in his masculine, and now we're going toe to toe. So it also depends on like how we show up energetically as well. Sometimes we really are warranting the behavior that we're getting, and that's not to say we're not worthy of love. We just haven't reached the maximum potential of love that we have to offer ourselves. So we are literally attracting, like you said earlier, we are matching where we're at, right? We date at the level of our self-esteem, which is why if you want a better version of love, you're going to have to love on yourself more so that you can raise that vibration.
Completely, completely. And the journey doesn't end. It just keeps going, right? But you will arrive at a point where you just like know the pieces of the puzzle fit into place. And you're so right. It's never about the other person. That person is simply a reflection of me. Yep. So if I want to change my external reality, I come back to self. I go heal that aspect of myself. And then either that person changes and meets us where we are at, or that person lovingly leaves our life. We learn our lesson and we keep moving forward until we meet the next person.
Absolutely. And I like what you said earlier about, you know, when you are in this, you know, space and you're, you know, taking care of self, but that necessarily like self-care is, you know, just an element. What I want to address though is our purchasing power right now. How much should we be purchasing for this self-care while we're in quarantine, while we're not doing much? Our spending habits, right? We want to manifest more money. So does that mean I'm spending more to take care of self? Or does that mean that I'm being thrifty and not taking care of self and loving on self? How should we be managing our finance in order to create abundance right now?
Yeah,
I think staying close with Amazon. Me and Amazon are like this right now.
Yeah, I hear you. I think the key word is not spending, but investing. Mm-hmm. Okay. So the question is like, what should I be investing in right now? And sometimes that might be investing in getting a facial or like getting my hair done. Other times that might look like putting $50, $100, $200 aside and putting it and buying cryptocurrency, or paying off a bit of credit card debt, or buying a course that's going to teach me something about myself.
Yeah.
And so we should always be looking for what am I being called to invest in, not spend in. Two different, very different energy between the two things.
Thank you for that tip. Yes.
Yeah. And it's going to look different. So for me at the moment, like, because I can't go out and do like the beauty things that I want to do, I've actually been investing and building a crypto portfolio. Mm-hmm. And like, that's really energizing to me because I'm building future wealth for future Lauren.
I'm so unfamiliar with crypto. Every time you bring it up, I'm like, Like that is like, I need to Google more about it because I feel like it's so high level for me, Lauren. I'm like, every time I hear you say that, I'm like, should I be investing? I don't even know enough about it.
Yeah, but can you see, like, I'm following my curiosity, and my curiosity, the most loving thing to do right now is for me to, like, explore new ways of building wealth for me and my future family. And so, and then I might wake up and my crypto portfolio is set up, and whatever I have in there is whatever I have. And then next week it might be going and hiring Spicy as a coach so I can go deeper into self-love, or listening to these trainings, or buying that particular book, which isn't even that expensive to buy because it's an investment in me attracting my purpose mate, right? And so it's never about spending, it's always about investing. Remember, it's just energy in motion. So when we understand that whatever we invest in, we're sending a very clear signal to the universe that says, this person is serious, they are ready for this. So when someone hires a matchmaker, it's not a transfer of money. What they're demonstrating to the universe is that, like, I'm ready and I will do whatever is required for me to have the person that I want in my life. You can't put a price
In
on that.
alignment with the belief, like that's more in alignment with what they're trying to manifest. Absolutely.
Totally. And I always know that if I invest instead of spend, my investment always has to have a return.
I think
Always.
that's beautiful too, because you said earlier, if you invest in a coach, right? If they know that there's an area that they're struggling with, but it's hard because you don't want to put this mirror up to yourself and you're like, oh, where am I weak? You know, what am I without? That sometimes that really is hard for us. It's a constant, you know, balance between like self, you know, deprecating behavior versus like being honest and realistic with yourself about things that you need to work on. Because at the same time, we're like, okay, well, love yourself, but also be realistic about where you suck. And so that sometimes gets like convoluted, you know, when we're already so tough on ourselves. But to your point about how seriously you take this, if you are not willing to invest in a coach to improve upon an abundance mindset, your finances, a matchmaker or relationship coach to improve the area that you are lacking, you won't invest if you do stumble upon a partner and even that partner, because that is going to be the biggest and most ultimate accountability partner that you will ever have. So if you can't hold a mirror up prior, that is your biggest mirror right there. Your partner is your straight up like selfie cam. So if you can't handle the heat before, you definitely aren't gonna be able to handle it when you get it into your life, if you get him into or her into your life.
Completely. And how you do one thing is how you do everything. So if you're being cheap and stingy in one area of your life, I can guarantee you're being stingy when it comes to love.
Very true. Very
It's
true.
all interconnected. Nothing is unrelated. It's all interconnected. Money is related to love. Love of self is related to love. All of it, it's all connected. So we just need to recognize that this is very much just a journey of personal evolution, and that it doesn't matter, like, where we're investing or what tool we use to fall deeper in love with ourselves. Because I could fall deeper in love with myself through the vehicle of business, which also calls in my purpose, mate, which is kind of, does that make sense? So the more that, like, I lean into all of these things, the more that I clean my money blocks, the more that I bring myself closer to my purpose, mate. It has to be, because it all brings us back to the same principle, which is I love myself and I know that I'm worthy of whatever I desire. You learn that principle, you clear all the blocks that block that in the way. What you want has to turn up. It has to.
People nervous about investing in themselves, no matter what that thing is. It's always this, you know, I'm willing to invest in other things that I can get like instant gratification for, or invest in other things that I know are like guaranteed, but I'm not going to invest in even like caring for myself or loving on myself or investing in something that's going to improve upon my life. And that is that shows in every facet or every area of their life when they operate like that.
And it's the difference between, like, a short-term strategy and a long-term investment strategy. You know that, like, if you go and invest in property or shares or crypto, whatever it is, that you are in it for the long haul. And you're probably not going to see a return on investment for a couple of years. But the problem is, we've been so conditioned in a quick gratification society that somehow, like, if I'm doing something wrong, if what I want didn't turn up instantly. Whereas, what if in actual fact, like, I spent a couple of years to me the purpose mate, my person, right? Then what am I, how do I benefit in the long term? Gosh, we'll make millions of dollars more together in our lifetime. I won't have to go through an expensive divorce one day. I will be a deeply happy, healthy woman with my beautiful children. Like we get so caught up in short term. So tell me, is it not worth the short term investment of healing those aspects of yourself in order to have that? Like it is for me, because I'm in this for the long run.
No, absolutely. And that's that's what I let all of my clients know too. I'm like, you are literally coming to me asking me to solve 30, 40 years of your life and then also double your income when I find your partner. I'm come on now, sign up right now. Like, what are you waiting for?
This is it. And this is the difference between like living life in a linear way. So A equals B equals C. We actually have the option of what I call a quantum leap, right? So why wouldn't I invest a little bit here in myself in order for me to meet my purpose mate that's going to exponentially change the course of my life and the wealth and abundance that I get to experience?
Yeah.
That seems like a pretty smart investment move to me. Yeah. Now, maybe I won't have an extra house to show for it here today or an extra couple of $1,000 in my bank account, but I'm playing a long game.
Oh, my gosh. You are so phenomenal. Let me tell you why. Because you bring up so many memories of like my ignorance to the fact that like I will invest in anything when it comes to relationships, love, like helping someone find something. But then you were like, so you're going to sign up for, you know, da 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 tool to help your business. And I'm like, oh, but the price. And you're like, Spicy, this is an investment in like,
you know, it's $15 a month.
But like that's what I'm saying, like that's why your like coaching is so needed too, because we it's where we, you know, put the importance on things that sometimes we have blockage that we're not even aware of. It shows up in love, it shows up in money, but both go hand in hand, because what's the number one reason for a divorce? Surprisingly, it's not infidelity, it is finance. And so you have two people who are in love that don't know how to, you know, balance their checkbook or, you know, lose money. Do you have any advice for couples right now that may be financially struggling from a, you know, things are going, you know, bad right now. Someone has lost their job and, you know, they don't know what they're going to do. How should the other partner maybe be showing up for them with this lack, you know, energy that's going on?
Yeah. Once again, it's inner work. Right. And so it's a matter of like, how do we, and if someone's in a state of stress, we can't see clearly, we can't think clearly. So it's our task as adults, and we can facilitate that for another person to bring more certainty into it. And that certainty might come through the form of support. That certainty might come through the port of the form of, you know, doing something from them that makes them feel more comfortable. It might just be like lending a listening ear and just holding space. Right. The other aspect of this that's really, really important is that we need to recognize that the money stuff is always tied up to old stories. Mm. And so the more that we can just allow those stories to come to the surface, the more that we can see those patterns at play for ourselves, like once again, awareness, bringing shining light into the areas that we don't want to shine, that just bringing that to the surface, talking about it, allows us to calm our nervous system, to share what we've been holding on to, which is usually the cause of a lot of stress. And then once we have lowered the stress levels, we're in a much better position to make better decisions and to come up with creative ideas to how to solve our problems. Because once again, it comes down to creativity. Creativity can't be accessed when we are in a heightened state of fight or flight.
Yeah. I was just going to say that fight or flight, because most of us grew up only knowing either or. And so really like standing up and addressing in a sensitive and compassionate and empathetic way to what your partner is going through, because that is a part of, if your partner's experiencing something, you're experiencing something. Okay. So, you know, with all of the fear and energy, you know, that's going on, I have, you know, people left and right that are in partnerships with someone who is suffering with what's going on right now.
Yeah.
And so how they show up actually energetically transfers to their partner. So if they both are in fear, you guys are staying in that energy. But if one of you shows up, you are able also into, you know, pour into that other partner, and with, you know, giving and support, belief, you know, confidence, that also is contagious, just as contagious as fear is.
And we are, like, once again, we're vibrational energetic beings. And what's happening at the moment is that a lot of people are regressing. So you're going to recognize that your partner might even be behaving in a manner that you don't quite recognize. You're like, this is so unlike this person. Yeah. It's because of what's happening collectively to us. We're going back to, like, old weird patterns of behavior, old emotions. Yep. We almost feel like we might be seeing, like, the inner child come out, mm-hmm. In a lot of people. And if we can recognize that, like, that isn't actually our partner, this is what happens to us when we are currently experiencing a lot of stress. So the question is, like, how do I facilitate, like you said, take care of yourself, bring your own higher vibration to the situation, but also with love and compassion, how can I be there for them and bring them more certainty and allow them and support them in bringing down their stress levels so that they can start to think more creatively and clearly?
Yeah, absolutely. And also, what about this opportunity? Seeing this as an opportunity to maybe, you know, it was their time to, you know, leave that position and step into something that they've been, you know, creative in or afraid to say yes to. I mean, I can't say enough how much of an advocate I am for you, for any entrepreneur that's considering, like, starting whatever business they are thinking about. You were always running, you know, these coaching programs around, you know, the abundance mindset and really how to, you know, accelerate your career and your, you know, finances. And so oftentimes, because we're in fear, we will tell our partner, no, you can't sign up for that program. No, you can't do X, Y, and Z. I don't believe that you're capable. That's not a good investment. When actually you supporting one is showing right love right there. And then two, yes, belief in them is also showing love. And then three, it encourages them to believe in themselves. And you, it's a return on your investment when you believe in your partner. Trust me.
Completely.
It's an opportunity that they're looking for. Like, this quarantine, everything that's going on may be that push that people needed to step out on their own that were living in fear.
Completely. And once again, like, we tell ourselves a story. We know that people create generational wealth in times like this. Mm-hmm. Like, this is the best. Like, yes, a lot of people are going to suffer. That's a fact, right? And then a lot of people are going to come out of this more evolved,
yep,
more attuned, wealthier, and more abundant in all shapes and forms than they have ever been in their life. Why? Because they decided that that's how it was going to be.
Yeah.
And it starts with a decision. And, like, we get to choose. Are we going to, like, flatline and, like, lie on the sofa? Or are we going to, like, bring that fighter through in us that says that, like, life is always working for me. I always make it work for me. Every investment I make always comes back to me.
Yep.
And, like, I always say to my clients, like, we're playing in a virtual reality game of life. What kind of game do you want to play?
Yeah.
Do you want it to be where you end up with Prince Charming at the end? All happy around the fireplace with your grandkids? Or are you going to keep telling the story that takes you further away from what you want? But you know what? People are addicted to fear. You know why? Because it gives them certainty. We get a kick from it. So we're like, oh, cool. Well, things are going to be terrible, but at least I have certainty that they will be terrible. As opposed to taking a leap of faith.
Yeah.
And recognizing that where I'm going, I may have never been before and I may not know what it looks like.
Yeah.
But I'm willing to take a chance on it because it's better than where I've been. So we have to be willing to let go of that. Like, can you feel how big that is for people?
Huge, which is why so many people are afraid to date after rejection. It works hand in hand, money and relationships. It's why. You know, the guy rejected them, the girl rejected them, you know, broken heart, multiple relationships, you know, mom and dad didn't make it work. So it's not going to work for me. It's the story that keeps, you know, playing over and over. And then they actually don't make a decision. They don't choose a partner. They actually avoid dating. They stay off of the market or choose people who are emotionally available so that they can predict the outcome in advance that they're going to get hurt. It's a self-fulfilling prophecy that I see all of the time. So that way they can really avoid the thing that they want.
I know. At least I can, you know, reaffirm that old belief that I have that everyone always rejects me or it never works out.
You can have love or you can be right, which is more important to you.
I love that. You can be right or you can have love. I'd rather have love, but that's a hard lesson to learn and it takes time.
Absolutely. Well, I'm happy that I have love and I'm happy that I have you.
Yes.
You have made me not even fall more in love with myself, but fall in love with money too. I want people to sign up for all of the programs that you are running right now. Yes. This is the perfect opportunity for them. So can you please share some of the stuff that you have going on so they can take advantage and benefit with their empire the same way that I have?
Yeah. So I have a few courses that I run. The first one is all around abundance and money mindset. So it's kind of like the stuff that we were talking about, the foundational, like how to manifest and what it really looks like. Not the stuff that people tell us it is, but like tangibly, like what does it really look like and where are you getting blocked? So that's an amazing place for people to start. And then for those people that are looking to start or launch a business, I have a business accelerator. So it's about getting to the 5-figure months, because we know that the more freedom, money is just a tool for freedom, that we open up in our life, the more that it allows us to go off and become who we're truly supposed to be, right? So those are the two things that I do. I find the intersection of that is incredible. And for me, it's very much like I want as many people as possible to know who they are, who they've always been, to let go of all the baggage of like what was like put on them and to step into their full potential. Why? Because like, look at the world. Like, we need more people that are out there being examples, that aren't living in fear, that are able to like stand up in the light of like everything that's happening in the world from a place of empowerment and freedom and to set the example. So that's my ulterior motive with all of this. I want a lot of people to be in loving relationships, raising beautiful kids that are going to change the world.
We want this.
We're on the same mission and purpose. When you and I just do it slightly differently, it's the same thing at the end of the day.
No, but it's true. Yours, you know, facilitates, and you know, mine does like this, you know, this similar mission, but they are also assists. They're like layups to each other. They, you know, they're assists when it comes to, you know, making sure that, you know, that dream happens. And so when you can have both of the things that your heart truly desires, makes life a lot worth, you know, living a lot more.
Yeah, completely. And then whatever piece of the puzzle has to come first, you know. So if you know it's love, go explore love. If you know it's business, go explore business. If you know it's like abundance, money, mindset, you go explore that first. And we're just gathering pieces of the puzzle that we bring together over time. But I think the key is like, just get started. Start somewhere. Invest somewhere. See where life takes you. Then you'll know the next step. And then life will just deliver love at your doorstep.
Right? Like how you received. I'm like, can everybody get a love care package? That's adorable. I absolutely love that. Okay, Lauren, you're going to have to tell everyone where they can find you. You know, what site is it? What's your social? Everything.
Yeah, so it's so easy to find me. You just have to look up Lauren Trillian, and I'm sure you're going to share that with everyone on Instagram. I've got a ton of stuff on YouTube. You can also check out my website for all of my programs. And then I always encourage people, just message me, email me. Let me know like what you're currently going through, what you know is the next piece of the puzzle for you, and I can always point you in the right direction.
I love it. And I'm going to challenge you right now, since you operate in such an abundance mindset. You are going to give us like the top 5 qualities that you are looking for in a lover in case someone hears this. Give us this rundown so we can put it in the universe, girl. We're putting it in the universe. Who is this man? Describe him.
Well, I think there has to be a huge piece around abundance, right? Someone that is open on all levels, that has a true knowing of self, that has a mission and purpose here in the planet, because I've got one as well. So I really want to meet someone that's a match in terms of that. They're a beautiful human being inside and out. And for me, it's really important that someone understands that we are spiritual beings. Mm. And that we're not here doing this on our own, that we have the ability to co-create with our fellow human beings and with this incredible universe to create so much love and abundance in this lifetime and beyond. So, yeah, I don't know if that's 5 things, but that's definitely what I'm looking for.
We went deep enough. And fellas, if that sounds like you, please email me at info@thespicylife.com. Ladies, if you know someone who that describes, if you have a brother, an uncle, yes, cousin, oftentimes we don't know how to describe what we're looking for. And it's that it's basic things that aren't on a higher frequency. But then the other element is that we don't tell enough people. If we were without a job right now, we would be letting the world know that we need a referral and to submit our resume. But when it comes to love, we don't do the same. And so if we're really trying to attract this partner, the more ears that hear it, the more that it lands, the better.
Completely agree. And thank you for inviting me to do that. And it's so true. Like, the biggest piece around this is like knowing to ask, mm-hmm, and then being ready to receive. And I'm 1,000% definitely ready to receive. Why? Because I've done the work. I know who I am. I know what I'm here to bring into the world. And I know because I truly love myself. I think this is key for everyone that's listening. I love myself so much that I know that allowing partnership into my life will facilitate that love on an even deeper level, so I can share that with humanity. So it has to, I'm ready for it, has to be here.
You can always play with my Twitter or stroke my Instagram at @spicymadi. You can go to thespicylife.com and make sure that you click and subscribe to this podcast, but also this is going to be everywhere on my social. And there you guys have it. You have just been spicy.